Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Ready enough.
Yeah.
Yep. Ready enough.
Yeah.
Prepared to die.
I'm always ready for that.
And we are live. Hello, everybody, and welcome to session 121 or 2. Jesus, it keeps getting away from me. Paphlios 5th edition. My name is JC or Jacob, and I am your dungeon master for tonight. And I'm joined by five wonderful people: James, Jazz, Suzanne, Alpha, and Helminia, our wonderful players for the evening. I don't have much to talk about, so I'd say let's get the music changed just a little bit to my favorite ambient track right now,
and let's get started. Really quickly while we're getting switched over, mm-hmm. Put in the context, I spoke a little bit about this. It's not going to last that long, but January would make 3 years.
Yes.
We're not going to get that far. My guesstimate is we're going to end right before, like, the December-January break begins.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, 3 years.
Happy 3 years.
That's, like, half as long as Alpha's been alive.
Alpha's a baby. I get it. Alpha's
not
young.
Not anymore.
Happy belated 18th birthday to Alpha.
Thanks, everyone.
Here, your birthday gift is being the one person who wasn't Alpha striked.
Wait, what?
Oh, we're going to die.
Uh-oh.
That's what you guys were calling it all week. So
it's true. I thought you were going to say that I was going to be the first one to die.
No. I mean, you're the furthest away from Lackham.
I mean, I laughed you out, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I would like you to finish up with whatever's going on over there. And
I'm doing my best.
I know, but like, finish that up and get over here.
You put the least ranged person on a ranged job.
There is three of those zombie ogres left. I think
you're
fine.
You can do it quick.
All right.
You thought wrong.
Where we last left off, you all had discovered in the Halls of Glory that there were people who were still alive, not thriving, but surviving. Unfortunately, one of your allies, Kylin the Druid, had passed away, but you found instead Zivin, Lixen, Jensen, and other dotted survivors underneath the arena. As you were getting the explanations and lowdowns from Zivin, as he had almost taken up a bit of a leadership role in the camp after O'Brien had been taken and Kylin killed, Rem and Zex pieced together that the Halls of Glory was actually multifaceted. It was an arena, yes, but it was also a temple to Kord. And in the middle of the arena, they started digging. What they discovered was a seal, a quote-unquote keyhole to the underground. What specifically is under there, they have no idea, because they decided, rather than trying to find a way to open the lock and unseal it, they needed to stop Lackham from knowing that they knew, and stop Lackham from making it there. They rested and recuperated before Rem, they had retreated to the demiplane's safety, had a premonition of something bad coming towards the Halls of Glory. You guys immediately pulled yourself back to the city and found an undead assault on the Halls of Glory with this mass of an undead wall dotted with undead ogres, and at the back of it, Lackham herself. The fight ensued and was quick and brutal, with you guys handily dispatching almost every single zombie, leaving only three badly burned zombie ogres behind. However, Lackham teleported into the middle of the Halls of Glory arena, and so Suna teleported all but Gilgamesh into the arena after her. Terra actually came with and struck a blow at the half dragonborn, half Asimir, but Suna teleported her out, and ironically to safety, as unbeknownst to each of you, you had been lured, brought into the middle, as a thin red light became a waterfall of red energy. And the last thing that was seen by Lixen, Terra, Jensen, and Gilgamesh was a red pillar of arcane energy sweep over all of you. And that's where we had left off. These next few minutes are dedicated to the second that you all first got hit. First and foremost, everyone but Gilgamesh. Or should I say Alpha. So that you can feel involved with this if you want to. I am going to commandeer Silex from James so that you can roll with them. If you would like to feel involved.
I would love to feel involved.
Okay.
I stepped away for a hot second. How many limbs have I lost?
None yet. We are still in the first second of when this happened.
Your dex is a minus one. Good luck.
None limbs left grief.
Well, that's not what we're starting with. James, be prepared to call out what it is.
Yeah.
The first one is an intelligence saving throw.
Oh, really? That one's a minus four.
Oh, wow. Okay.
What's going on here?
Everyone but Gilgamesh is making an intelligence saving throw as the column of energy passes through you all.
Is this a magical effect?
This is hella magical. There's no denying it.
Oh, you get advantage.
I get advantage.
Gil gets advantage. Or not Gil. Silex.
Nice.
It's 21 for me.
Well, it wasn't much better.
We got a 22.
Silex got an 11. Minus four really hurts, huh?
12?
Okay.
Probably a failure.
Does this answer? I bet DC is like.
Nime, what did you get?
I didn't realize I was muted in the call. What the heck am I rolling right now?
Intelligence saving throw.
Oh, I'm stupid! Okay.
Well, that's what the roll is going to determine, really.
Oh, my God.
Remember, you have your thing.
Indomitable.
My thing.
If you fail a save, you can choose to reroll it.
Oh, yeah. I'm totally rerolling that because I rolled a 4.
Mm.
Oh, that's so much better. 18.
All right.
I don't think it's going to be enough.
I don't think it's going to be enough either. But
well, I've got a lovely surprise for you.
Everyone fails.
Nime, you and everyone who rolled higher... save.
Oh.
Yay!
Sorry, Silex.
Silex and Suna do not. So, we're going to roll some dice.
Can't believe my 12 didn't do anything for me.
Yeah, it's unfortunate.
Come on.
Well, it's not Lackham, but it's not only Lackham.
I do need to know if this counts as something caused by an undead, because... That's relevant for me.
I mean, technically.
For the scarab, correct?
All the people in the blood cloud. Dead.
A necromancy spell or a harmful effect originating from an undead creature. It is a harmful effect.
It is.
And it does originate from the undead creature.
I don't know. I think he has a case here.
This might be relevant.
You know. Why not?
Nice.
If there is something you want to use it for.
I will keep that. I will see how I feel as we go.
Later.
Eight. Two.
I had a fucking legendary item on me all this time. did
so,
did Suna roll with
advantage? Yes.
Damn.
I rolled a 9 and a 5.
So, full damage. Full damage will be 65 points of psychic damage.
Okay.
Yikes.
I take 33, right?
Yes.
Oh my god.
You're immune to psychic damage, so it don't matter.
I am not immune to psychic damage.
Silex. Silex is fine.
Silex is immune to psychic damage.
W Silex. Screaming. Silex just has like fucking.
Silex is good. Silex has no thoughts.
What for Christmas going on?
Silex.
What was half? Sorry.
33.
Okay, cool.
So that is what Rem, Zex, and Nime take.
What am I taking?
33 psychic damage.
Okay. Guys, I think my sheet is wrong.
What was that? Psychic static or something?
JC, do you remember what my HP was supposed to be? I have 139, but I don't think that's right.
I can pull it up for you really quick.
Right. Hit, yes, so I believe you were at full, aren't you?
No, I know. I meant, like, my full HP. On my sheet that I have right now, it's showing up as 139, but that's not right.
146.
Thank you so much.
Of course. I'm here to help.
How many points again? I'm so sorry.
33.
Thank you.
You guys are going to have such a hard time with this if this is how it's going to go. Like,
I mean, I'm doing great.
Because Silex took no damage.
Uh-huh.
All right. So, next... you basically what happens here, you're watching as this cascading of red pulls through you, and you can hear these whispers peel into your ears and pierce into your minds, these kind of wailings, these groans, these desperate pleas of people. These are the voices, the collective conscious of those who have been killed, died, and placed into the sky above Greywall. Passing through your systems.
Can I pick one voice out?
This will be nearly impossible, but I will let you try.
What is it?
Let's go with perception.
Can I have advantage? Because I'm in it?
No.
You should... 24, so probably not.
No.
Too much.
I'm curious on who you were trying to hear.
I would just see if one, like, came out.
Oh, if, like, there's a master voice?
Yeah, like if one was able to, like, oh, shit.
No, it's a symphony of pain.
Oh, my favorite.
Can I try to hear Kylie?
It's my favorite Italian opera.
That'd be cool.
Sure, Zex. Give it her go.
No, not as bad. Oh, wait, no, that's a 14. It's a 30.
30.
Total.
That should do
perfect.
This way, Bart's...
Oh, wait, no, 28.
No, sorry. So no.
Unfortunately.
30 is the DC for near impossible.
No.
That's just how it goes. But let's continue on with what happens immediately after that. It feels slow as you feel all the voices put through, but for those on looking, they see the red pillar and then it ignites in this eruption of flame and heat. I now need a dexterity saving throw from everyone.
What's Silex's dex mod?
Is it also magical?
It is.
Okay.
So all of this counts as magic.
29.
This was Dex.
This is Dex.
What was 21?
Okay.
I also got a 21.
Okay.
What was Silex's modifier?
-1.
-1. Okay. Ooh, 18.
Okay.
29.
You guys are just real good at Dex saves.
I literally took a feat for it, I hope so.
Yeah.
I mean, if I were there, I could see it. So, you know.
So you'll all be taking half. I'm going to roll some more dice.
How many dice?
Specifically.
How many of what certain kind of dice might you be rolling?
Seventy-two is full.
Oh,
that's 36 half.
36 halved.
That's fire damage.
This is fire damage.
So quarter, so it's half to 10
for you. Yep.
What was half?
Fire damage.
Zex is resistant to fire.
No, what was half?
36. Hey guys, my HP's at the funny number.
I just realized that for some reason your guys' HP isn't there. They've been stolen.
I noticed that
from
last
you.
Time, but
that's unfortunate.
I decided to not say anything.
You have to set up the bar.
I know. It just went away for some reason. I don't know why.
Let me show you what I'm at. And just this, if stream can see it.
It's okay.
I've gone from there to there.
Yep.
I mean, yeah, that happens. That's a thing.
Yeah, those of you that are in roll 20, if you can, just put your HP into the green slot and the bar will pop up.
Oh, yeah.
Beep, beep, beep. Oh, I forget how little damage I've taken.
Thank you. As this is the fireball of heat that pulls out like an atomic blast, searing your skin. Then, and only then, does the collapsing rock of the roof of the temple catch up to you. As you watch as large chunks of stone fall and slam into the sand pit, Gilgamesh. I need a strength saving throw from everyone.
Is this magical?
This is not. This is the one that is not.
This is, you know, the ceiling.
This is the ceiling.
JC,
yeah.
Is Lackham still in the middle with us?
Oh, yeah.
What the frick?
With the saving throw for Silex, he's immune to...
And the last thing was a magic...
He still needs to roll to see if he's trapped.
Fine. He has the plus six.
Whoa!
The only good one. What's up?
And the last thing was a spell?
It was a magical effect, but it was not a spell.
Is this a spell?
Strength?
No. She's not... Lackham is not casting this. Mm. I know you just want
a
deck.
A natural event.
You said a strength saving throw?
Strength saving throw.
With
the I got advantage. A 19.
Oh, Alex got a, he got a 8.
Why do you have advantage, what? Dominia?
It's a magical effect.
No, this is the roof just collapsing on you guys.
Fresh dice. Is this a harmful effect originating from an undead?
No, this is the roof collapsing.
The ceiling is the ceiling.
Effect. It's not undead, from though. An undead.
I've got an 8.
Okay.
I got a natural 20.
Okay. I've only heard a couple people.
I suppose I got a 19 then.
Okay.
I got a 19 as well.
All right. It seems like Silex and Rem are the ones that have failed this time.
It's so ironic. 19
passes?
19 does pass, yeah.
Damn. All right.
Nice.
As...
I never would have thought that.
It is 52 points of bludgeoning damage.
It's a 26 halved.
Okay.
Is it over? Still alive over there?
Oh, let me show you. Let me show you. I'll show your ass.
Yeah, I'm not looking so great.
Chop.
Oh my god.
I'm not feeling so good, Mr. Stark. I'm not feeling so good. Any more saves?
One more. This is a constitution save.
Is it against magic?
No.
Is it a spell?
No.
You said no magic.
No magic.
Yeah. Damn. I can be so hopeful.
Don't worry. All of you have made it. This is for status effects.
Nat 1? I'm going to hell, man. Going
Silex
to hell in this building. Ah, fuck. I'm hella concussed right now.
25.
Okay.
I apparently am bad at the dice rolling game. You said it was a +5, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, he got a 9.
Oh my god.
I'm really bad at the dice rolling game.
Sin, I got a 25. And Nime got a 27. Yes. Wonderful.
2 and 4.
Alrighty. As what happens is the roof slams in, falling down in these large segments, and the sand is kicked up into this dust storm. You first watch as Silex is crunched underneath this portion of stone that kind of pushes him to the ground, still moving but temporarily immobilized. Zex, you try to dart out of the way, but you get clocked with part of this rock and your leg trapped underneath it. Suna, Nime, you guys are able to dodge out of the way and evade the majority of the debris falling on you, and most importantly, are not currently blind or deafened. Rem, a large section of the ceiling falls over you, trapping you underneath right now. You are badly concussed. You are blind and deaf for the moment. As we're going to swap.
What save did I fail that caused me to get restrained under here? Or was that just luck of the draw?
Luck of the draw.
Okay.
As you, Nime and Suna, see first, before the onlookers can see themselves, the dust slightly clears, but it is a battleground. War-torn. Destroyed. Nime, you're the closest.
What does that mean?
It means that you can see that, well, not... Lackham did not get out of the way. Well, you kind of suspected it. Everyone was talking. You look and you can see Lackham's bottom half, her legs and lower torso have been crushed by a rock. And you can see Lackham's face pooling into this. It looks like her skin's melting slightly as you watch it turn slowly. Her smile turns into a stream of water coming off of her body. As this Lackham, not real, chuckles to herself.
What a simulacrum.
And the head falls off.
Okay.
You can hear your allies coughing. Any moans of pain. Suna, you've avoided the majority of the blast, the crater, but you are not unscathed by any means. Gilgamesh, Suna is the first one that you can see on the edge of the smoke. They're badly bloodied and bruised. What do you guys do?
If nobody else, or I'm sure everybody else has noticed, but Nime is just going to scream out to the party, it was a fucking simulacrum. And we need to get the fuck out of the pit.
You hear a bang. Not really a bang, but like the sound of something slamming from in Rem's direction.
What is it?
You can guesstimate that it's Rem slamming his gauntleted hand on the stones, perhaps to signify that he can't get out. It's very slow, and it kind of cuts across it. Just bang.
Can I see Rem from where I am?
It takes a second, and then you begin seeing those of your allies. Nime is standing up. She is the only one standing up besides Yusuna.
Can I see Zex?
You can. You can see Zex and Rem, and you can see the stones moving, slightly shifting in a larger pile that would denote Silex.
Yeah, I'm not so worried about Silex. I'm going to do this across two turns so that I'm not using points.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to vortex warp Rem to me, and I'm going to vortex warp Zex to me.
Okay. Rem, you feel your body shifting.
Is that unwild magic?
A slight weightlessness is being pulled on you. Do you try to resist?
I'm blind, right?
You're blind and deafened. You just feel your body being interacted with.
This should feel familiar to him, though.
Does it?
I mean, you've been transported via Suna before. It feels
what my magic feels like.
It feels like a slight weightlessness before you're, like, transported via arcane means, teleportation.
But everyone's, like, does Zex's teleportation magic feel the exact same way? Or am I able to differentiate it's different? Because if I don't know it's Suna's magic, I'm not letting it happen. I am crushed, blind, and deaf.
I'm pretty sure we've previously denoted that people's magic feels differently so that we can denote who's casting what
in these situations. And think, well, JC, it's your discretion. If I don't know it's Suna based upon how the magic feels, I'm declining because I'm assuming Lakum's trying to take me.
I want to see how the wild magic roll pans out. If it's a failure, it might be a little bit easier to denote.
Okay. It was a success.
All right. Rem, we're going to have you roll insight with disadvantage.
Fucking. How dare you not take my fingerprint and lock me out for 30 seconds?
All because nothing bad is happening on my end, Rem gets disadvantage?
No, it's because Rem's blind and deafened.
Blind.
The senses that they generally use to perceive an insight are hindered.
Oh, you should.
The disadvantage insight comes to a 16.
It doesn't feel hostile. You have a good gut feeling.
I will allow this.
Okay. Rem is immediately unrestrained. At the end of the turn, Rem, you get to make another con save. Zex, you get to make a con save. Silex, I don't believe, can be blinded or deafened, so he's just good.
Was I blinded and deafened?
You were deafened, I think. Oh no, you didn't. Did you fail the con save?
No, I rolled a 16.
That's a failure. So that yes.
Okay.
So yes. Con save.
That's a failure again.
Okay. So you're Brian still deafened. All right. So Rem, you shake it off. Your ears are ringing, but you can kind of hear your own cough come to you as you spit up some dirt and sand and rubble. Suna, you attempt to vortex warp Zex.
Yeah.
Okay. We're gonna do the same insight check for Zex. Wild magic for Suna.
Wild magic's good.
Wild magic's good.
17 for insight.
Good gut feeling.
Okay, I'll let it happen.
Zex is no longer trapped underneath a rock as Suna pulls with magic the two of you over. Silex can make a strength saving throw. Alpha, if you want to roll that again.
What am I rolling again?
Silex is re-rolling a strength save.
Okay. I believe with a plus 6, if I remember correctly?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
That is a 17.
He's still stuck. Sounds good. Speaking of which, though, for Gilgamesh, are you doing anything? You see Suna at the edge, and she begins teleporting arcane, basically flickering the half of the party over to her.
I mean, can I reasonably say that it looks like Suna has this pretty under control?
Mm-hmm.
Probably.
Like, you know, like, control enough that I can deal with whatever's happening outside and feel okay with what she's doing.
Unless you see Lacom over there, it's probably our Similacom left. So.
As far as I'm concerned, I don't, but unless JC tells me otherwise.
You do not. So we can say for the next couple of turns, the zombie ogres are being handily dealt with by you. With the disadvantage that the cloak gives them, I do not think they're going to be able to even lay a hand on you.
And if they do, it's not going to be for very much damage.
No.
I don't imagine it's going to be a lot. So, fine if you want to roll like a general like attack or something, but I think I agree that they won't
be able to do good. Much. I think the biggest thing was the seal being shot. So over the next couple of turns, you basically Rem, Zex kind of regain their bearings. Silex is muscling his way out from underneath a rock that he has been partially buried under. What are you guys doing?
Can I look up?
Yeah.
What do I see? Should I roll perception?
You're welcome to roll perception.
I'd love to. Ooh. 18?
18. Well, as to be expected with the roof of a temple caving in, there's no roof there anymore.
Weird.
It leads way to the sky. The sky no longer has a overarching tint of red. It's this muddled, lightning blue and gray. This darkened cloud cover with blue lightning pulsing from cloud to cloud like a thunderstorm is rolling through. The colors have shifted. There's no longer, as you guys put it, a blood cloud.
How long until the dust settles from the laser?
It's probably going to take like a full minute or two. Nime's talking about the simulacrum, if there's any extra conversation that needs to be had about that. But for the time being, you all are quite literally catching your breath.
Rem is still like spread eagle on the ground. He has not gotten up.
Mm-hmm.
He's not dead, but he hasn't moved.
I'm not very good at it, but can I make a medicine check?
You moving over to Rem?
As you get close to him, you hear a swear that you probably can't make out. It's in Gnomish. And in the same instance, all of your wounds are gone.
This is important, though. Nime, were you starting to move towards Rem?
Yes.
Are you going through the okay. hellscape that's going on here?
Nime, make a perception check.
Perception. Okay, that is a... sorry, that is a 19.
19. Nime, you take a step. The stone... As you're in the middle of the crater, along this sandstone, and as you step, you feel it shift. A ground that isn't totally secure.
Shit. So I can't move towards him, is what you're saying?
No, you can.
Like,
make of it what you do. The ground is solid, but you feel okay. the stone shift underneath you.
Like cracked can tiles?
Can I make a acrobatics check to get over to him safely?
Absolutely.
Okay. That is a dirty 20.
All right. Nime, you safely kind of steady yourself for a second and then push off the rock. You feel it shift underneath your feet in the opposite direction that you push off on, but you have enough force that you land outside of the center of the crater and make your way up towards the others. At this point, Silex has been able to unrestrain himself and kind of just moves in a general direction out from the middle of the crater.
Okay.
So, was Rem casting a healing spell?
Yes, I was. You hear a gnomish slur, and then everyone's wounds are gone. As in the pettiest way possible, mass heal has been activated.
Woo!
And, you know, since Gil is untouched, I should have more than enough.
No, not untouched. I've been dealt damage.
How much damage?
7.
You can have 7.
You can... You, you
is
can
the range that far?
Fuck yourself. No, it's 60 feet.
I was gonna say it's like you're getting the 4 up here, like parsed up.
What am I gonna do?
You're no longer blind, deafened, and if you had any diseases, you don't have any of those anymore.
Oh, thank you.
Sonic's gonna have what's left over.
Cool. Is there enough left over?
And
a full.
Yeah, and for the sake of it, I am going to like I can't manually. Put in that I have 2 ninth level spells, like spell slots.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's just keep that in mind.
Okay.
All right. As your wounds mend themselves in a minor miracle, the lingering pain. In all of your guys' heads from the sound of the deceased moving through your brains does not completely leave. That will stay with you.
Does one need to be... what is the word? Like... Could I borrow Rem's broom? Rem, can I borrow the broom?
Rem is just spread eagle on the ground and doesn't seem inclined on talking. So if you grabbed it and took it, he probably wouldn't say no.
Okay, I'm going to take the broom.
Okay.
And assuming it works for me, I'm going to fly. I'm going to leave the temple through the gaping hole in the ceiling.
Uh-huh.
Or, I guess, the lack of ceiling. Mm-hmm. And get above the building so I can kind of see out across to the city center.
Of course. You course... course your way through the sky and the opening of the Halls of Glory, and you peer out. You can see over the destroyed ruins of Greywall. You're looking towards the center.
Yeah.
You can still see that obsidian tower standing high above the other sections, although there is an odd new addition. The clouds, the gray masses that have lightning dotting between them, are surrounding the top couple floors of the building, pulling up in this odd conal structure to cover and obfuscate the top of this building. And you can see it spiral in almost a small depiction of a cyclone cascading upward, occasionally alighting with blue light. That's what you see.
Let me think on that. Someone else should do something.
Gil, at this point, you've handily dispatched of the zombie ogres.
I guess I'll head back inside then. See what the situation's looking like.
I'd like to make an arcana check and simply ask the question, what the fuck?
A good question.
Gil, you can see three out of the four of your party members. Suna is not present. Rem is still lying down. Zex might have pulled himself up to a sitting position at this point. And Nime is standing over the two of them. Almost like naturally her hands have kind of moved to her hips as she's very frustrated, to say the least.
Can I, is Rem on his back or on his stomach?
He's on his back. He's like spread eagle, just looking up.
Can I, like, you know how, like, dogs, like, the mother of a dog will pick them up by, like, the loose skin on, like, their neck?
Mm-hmm.
I want to do that, but kind of with his cloak, like, just below his neck. So just kind of pick him up by that and, like, not even necessarily prop him on his feet, but just kind of pick him up until he starts to, like,
sit put himself, up a fight. And then yeah.
I'll stand him up.
All right.
Gilgamesh. And if he doesn't put up a fight, then I'm just holding him.
You just kind of pull yourself over the side of the railing, land with a thump in the sand pit. Step over and hoist Rem by his cloak.
Roll a strength check.
I would love to. Has it been a minute? Has it been more than a minute?
It has.
The beginning.
Yes, because it takes that... I said it was taking a minute or two for dust to clear.
That's fine. 23.
I don't do it. The DC was 5.
I just wanted physically, to see that one. I was going to say, the only thing I could do is get a nat 1, and that would put me right on 5.
Yeah. Rem makes no attempt to stand on his own. He seems to be lost in thought. As I'm going to roll an arcana to determine, what the fuck?
So yeah, I mean, at this point, I'm just kind of holding him. Almost like a bag, you know?
Mm-hmm.
16. What the fuck?
Well, looking up at the sky that is no longer red, you assumed it was...
17.
That, concentrated into one force?
Why?
You don't know. You hope it wasn't to... You hope it wasn't being used as a weapon against you?
I mean, with my new vantage of about, you know, taller than usual because I'm being lifted,
mm-hmm.
What do my gnome eyes see?
You look... I mean, the center of the arena was struck.
Yeah, but what's down there?
Well, it happens that the symbol that you guys buried of the skull with the symbols of the ascended around it were there in the middle. It might be because of the rubble, but you don't see that symbol right now. And you could have sworn it was in that spot that has been completely cleared away by the blast.
Senator, I heard the clank of loose stones.
Can I go poke it with my sword?
Sure. The sword isn't exactly enough to make it shift of rock. But the sword, the tip of your scimitar scrapes along the corner.
Does it seem like it's open down there?
You will have to put more force than poking it with the tip of a sword.
Okay, I'll hit it with the sword then. I'm not afraid of dulling the edge.
Normal sword. You slash the edge of it, and there's this kind of deep groove left in it. Again, slashing force might not be the best method of seeing if a stone can move, especially one that is that large.
Am I seeing him do this? Am I?
Yes, you are. You're technically one of the least harrowed people in the group right now. So
I mean, probably, yeah. I'm going to just kind of call down to him and just ask, do you want some help?
I'm going to whistle at Silex like a dog and trying to get him to come over here.
I mean, Silex just knows what you're doing, so he moves.
I'll have Silex do it instead. Punch it.
At this point, I kind of want to hoist Rem up onto like my shoulder as if he's like an infant child.
Gotcha.
Because he's basic, to me at least, he's basically the size of a child. Maybe that'll give him a better vantage point to ask what the fuck.
Yeah.
I have the best vantage point to ask what the fuck.
Silex takes his hand and puts it against the stone and shoves forward, and you hear it move. The stone rakes across the back. One of the two larger pieces of the roof partially covers and hinders it, and there's this terrible scratch that is drug as Silex pushes. But you see that it was covering something. And it moves freely.
There's just an open hole down there now.
You peer in. This is not as nicely maintained as the Halls of Glory. This is not as nicely maintained as the Chamber of the Ascended in the Lost City. This looks like the most naturally forming set of spiral stairs, rock-formed, uneven, and treacherous, but unmistakably a set of stairs that leads down.
I am going to call down on my ring. So I'm assuming everyone can see that the sky has changed once again. That cloud is swirling around Lackland's tower thing in the middle of the city. Do you guys find anything down there?
A big hole with a spiral staircase in it.
Staircase. I was gonna say we should go to the tower, but without an entrance to the tower.
I do think the tower is the next place we need to go, though. I mean, if Lackham isn't here, then stands to reason that they'd be there.
Who's to say we're not just being drawn out, though?
Do you want me to fly over there and see if I can see anything?
I don't think I mind the idea.
How long would that take me to do to get there, JC?
It would definitely be enough for the rest of the party to, like, if they had needed to do short rest, probably do short rest activities. Just because you're going alone and you're scoping it out, I'd say if you're being careful and not rushing, it would probably be half an hour there, half an hour back.
Okay.
Depends on how careless you are. If you're careless, you can take less time.
If there's no objection, I'm going to go do that. On the way there and back, I'm going to be keeping below building level.
Okay.
I will do something once you finish up with...
I need to roll anything?
I mean, just you start flying. Tell me what you're looking for. What are you trying to see?
I guess on the way it wouldn't hurt to look at the undead presence within the city while I'm on the way.
Okay. You can see that the undead presence is actually, I wouldn't say tame, but there were definitely those surges of undead, the 150 so undead that had a assaulted all of you were definitely from, were definitely like undead that might have been hidden in buildings or such. They were definitely being kept aside for this purpose. And so you aren't seeing a lot of smaller undead, normal humanoid undead, but you are seeing patches of undead ogres and trolls and giants that are roaming the streets in packs of 2 to 4.
Okay. When I get to the city center with the tower, is there anything different going on at kind of my below building level? Like if I peeked around a corner, what would I see?
You would see roaming undead giants. You do not see anything majorly different.
Okay. Nothing different with the tower necessarily.
Besides the cloud? No.
Okay. Now for the fun part. Let's see how this goes. I would like to fly up level with where the top of the tower would be. How close would I have to get? Like, can I see anything just from like floating up, or would I have to get closer?
So you are not able to fly above the cyclone that is blocking the top. Are you trying? So like there are several levels. Like, how are you trying to do this? You can give me a distance that Suna is comfortable with. I know that you were like lower on street, like around street level when you started. Like, how close does Suna think that she needs to get, and then how high up does she go before she gets uncomfortable?
I think I need to be able to see the top of the tower. I don't know how far that is.
That would mean you'd be having to pass through the cyclone to see the top of the tower. The top of the tower is engulfed in the cyclone.
And you're telling me I couldn't get in it?
Unless if you wanted to fly through the cyclone.
Fuck it.
Yeah?
Let's try it.
Okay. You are going to make some checks for me.
Hey, she's immune to lightning and thunder damage.
I know.
Okay, this will be fun.
Probably some bludgeoning from the wind or some shit.
Also, if you get blown off of the broom, it will be painful.
Seatbelt.
No, it won't be painful.
I have a rope connected.
No one said a goddamn thing about the seatbelt, and you know it.
I have a parachute.
So we are going to make the dex saves don't matter, because if you fail them, you take lightning damage. The con saves do not matter, because if you fail them, you take thunder damage. What matters is the strength saving throws.
Okay.
I am going to roll. It is a d4. It is how long it takes you to actually fly through the cyclone.
Okay.
I got a 3. There will be three total strength saving throws.
Okay. I'm gonna do it, but
not because I'm not happy about it.
Would you allow me to spend points to give myself luck on every roll?
Oh, that's totally up to you. You're good.
Okay. I guess I should start keeping track of points then.
Probably.
I must have used some last week. Okay. So, first, it's a dex save?
Dex and con do not matter. The ones that do matter is strength.
It's strength. Okay. And is this a magical effect?
Yes.
Thank God. Thank Mistra.
She'll take your thanks.
Ooh. Dirty 20?
Dirty 20.
Oh, wait. I get a D4.
Is enough. You move through this and you can see a section of wind buffeting you. Where is the dice? There it is.
Here we go again.
You take 7 points of bludgeoning damage, halved down to 4. Okay. And you do not get blown off the broom. Second one.
Ew. That's bad. So 12.
12. Okay. You'll take 8 points of bludgeoning damage as you begin pulling yourself up and off. Rem did heal you, didn't he?
Yep.
I did do that.
Okay.
That I forgot to do my thing.
Your thing?
Nothing.
There is one last one, but since you are not at half health, it doesn't immediately push you off. It just gives you disadvantage on the final strength save.
So it's even.
Yes.
If I use tides, will that give me advantage?
It will give you advantage again.
Is that worth doing today? It's
up to you.
It comes back. It comes back if I cast a spell, so I might as well.
Okay.
And then I am using luck again as well.
All right.
That looks a bit better. So that's a dirty 20.
That is enough. You take 4 points of damage, half to 2. And you fly through this, the wind and water whipping your face, and you push through. Not being someone who is overtly experienced with flying, you're kind of wobbling for a second, and you are basically looking for what this could be. Any spot of landing, anything at all. And as you break through, you push onto the top of the tower. you are immediately made aware as the wind and such dies down to a smaller level, and you only hear the crackling of lightning in the background with the dull chorus of muted wind behind you. You can see the tower lit slightly in this vibrant blue color. The stone dark with a wooden hatch on the end that you have pulled through. There are two things more for me to describe. One thing you will see regardless. The other, I need you to roll the perception check.
Okay. I don't see it. Four?
Four? All right. Your eyes are immediately drawn to the one figure on the tower. Standing opposite of you, her back turned towards you, the cloak slowly shifting in the wind, is Lackham, standing on top of the tower. She turns, and although it fades nearly immediately, you can't help but catch a spark of surprise coming from her brow. Do you land?
No.
So there you are, hovering above the tower. You can see the cyclone pushing above as Lackham was looking out of the cyclone. She's over on one specific side, and although you don't know what she's doing, she does look like she was preoccupied with something, like someone who was pulled away from a paper they were writing at their desk. And with that, she looks at you, and you can hear her voice pull out over the wind and lightning. I did not expect you to be so punctual. Or so stupid.
You know, who's really to say? And I'm going to speak into my ring and just say I found a Lackham.
As you say that, I would like you to, well, you see a green light. Roll initiative.
Wait.
Nope. Roll initiative.
We don't gotta be like that.
Oh, but we do.
I'm gonna do craziest shit here in a moment. 16.
16 is, well, we'll find out. 16 beats her. You see the green light as she pulls up her finger. What do you do?
Well, here goes for my crazy shit. I'm gonna do it back at her.
You're gonna disintegrate?
This is so fucking funny.
I'm gonna do it.
All right.
Spider-Man meme.
You point, she points. She is going to attempt to counterspell. I have her level locked in. And does she get to cast it? I'm not hearing anything.
Fifth level counterspell?
On her?
Yeah.
All right. She counterspelled at disintegrate, so that's a 6, so you will need to roll for your counterspell.
Okay. What am I rolling?
You roll a charisma check.
Okay.
And you have a DC 16 to make.
18.
Your counterspell, you watch as basically she puts up her finger and you pull down your finger. And it's this kind of like the Harry Potter, like Harry versus Voldemort, as the two green beams clash into each other. And yours pushes through and past, and she will make a dex save now.
I should also note for this, last session I had used a 6th level slot, so I had to use a 7th level for that disintegrate.
Okay. That is going to be an 18 for Lacum.
Doesn't she have to roll?
I think that failed, because my DC's a 19.
Her counterspell got counterspelled. Your DC's a 19?
Oh, yep.
Yeah.
All right, she is going to legendary resistance that then. Please roll your damage.
Rude.
Well, no damage if she makes it. So the spells interact with each other and then push off.
11, 12, 13.
Disintegrate doesn't do any damage if you fail or if she makes the save. It's an all or nothing. So you watch as the two green beams hit and yours wins out, but she's able to skew it just enough that it pushes past her face and blows off a section of the tower. I'm going to have you snap remake a perception check.
Okay. I should like to note that after this, I have another thing for my...
I'm sure you're quickening. I know.
Maybe not. 19 plus 21.
21. The disintegrate, as you know, if it misses, disintegrates the terrain that it hits. And as such, it has destroyed a section, a lip of Lacum's tower. This exposes it to the outside, and you can see now revealed something's hanging off the side of the tower. A glass case with a body inside of it. It looks like it's hovering there, but as you got over a 20... you see for a slight instance as the color from the disintegrate pushes away, it highlights a small ethereal chain that looks like it is taut and pulling against the lip of the tower. That's what you see.
Good question. How tall is this tower?
This tower is... Oh, thank you so much for asking.
Very important.
Jesus. 210 feet.
Ooh, that's a little short for me.
Still your turn. You've used your action.
The blue is the edge of the tower?
Yes.
Okay. I am going to fly over past the edge of the tower.
Okay.
And then I'm just gonna like you know how like people like turn a canoe or like a kayak over.
Uh-huh.
I'm just going to kind of turn the broom over and just...
And just dip?
Fall. Just fall, yeah.
Okay.
Am I in free fall?
For the moment, if you let the broom be in free fall, yes, you are.
Can I react to me falling?
Yeah.
You already used your reaction, though.
You did, for counterspell.
Mm. We'll do another old trick. When I get within 90 feet of the ground.
All right, so
I'll just click the vortex board.
So you moved there and then just started booking it.
Yeah.
Gotcha, gotcha. Sounds good.
I need gone.
You need gone. You are going to push through the storm again. So there's going to be, let's just do three rapid fire strength checks to see whether you're knocked off of the broom. Because if you start falling right now without the broom to guide you, you're just going to hit the ground before you can react.
Okay.
So three strength saves?
That's... uh, 16.
Okay.
18.
Okay.
And dirty 20.
Okay, so you are good on all of them, so... altogether, all three of the damages halved comes out to you take a total of 8 damage, but you stay on the broom, pushing through and down. Lackham does something. You don't know what.
What?
And you've pushed through pushing through, and you've just broken out of the edge of the cyclone. You've moved in total probably about, 20 feet down, so 190 feet left to go on the building. It is now your turn.
Can I, from here... I just want to start heading straight back to the Halls of Glory.
Alright, so now at 190 feet, you're just going to level out and just start coasting.
Yeah, I'm just going to go as fast as I can back.
Gotcha.
I don't think Long Strider would make me go faster.
It would not make you go faster. Alright.
That's fine.
And with that, you escape Lackham. You make your way back. The rest of you have, we'll cut the return trip probably in half because they're throwing caution to the wind. However, what are the rest of you doing?
Sent you a question.
There is not.
Please?
No. It was a red hot thing. Everything was vaporized.
You ruined my cinematic moment.
Cautiously approaching the staircase.
All right. You.
Is there like a middle to it?
There is not. It hugs the edge and spirals.
So can I see how far down it is?
It's too dark. Your dark vision does not reach far enough.
So at least 60 feet?
More than 60 feet.
Can I grab a pebble and drop it down there and listen for it to hit the bottom?
Sure.
Cool.
You do not hear it hit the bottom.
Okay. I will instead, let me make sure I have the thing to do this. I'm going to grab another pebble. I'm going to cast light on it, and then I'm going to drop it down the hole.
All right. You go and drop, and you just watch as it... this shimmer of yellow light disappears. You watch it go for maybe about 5-10 seconds before it disappears from your view. It gets too dim. Or there's nothing for the light to reflect off of.
Yeah. Well, I suppose there's nothing else to be done but wait then, for me at least.
Gil, Rem, Nime, anything from the rest of you?
I mean, I'm just kind of still letting Rem vibe on my shoulder until he does something else. I'm considering it a bonding time for us. This is the closest Rem and I are ever going to get to, like, having a night on the town and getting drinks, you know? It's... the world is ending and I'm letting Rem be on my shoulder for a little while.
You're like, there, it's okay. And I'm just like, I got airstrikes.
It's like, oh, I can see every equation and none of them are good.
The math is math and I'm mad about it.
I'm upset. But you know, other than that, even if he does get off, no. I mean...
oh, I'm here against my will now.
No, you're allowed to get off. I'm just saying, like, I'm not doing anything.
Okay.
I think I would beat you out in strength checks basically every single time. No, I would. Come on. Don't. No, I would.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Roll.
That is a, let me make sure, 18.
I'm rolling acrobatics because I can do that.
Oh, well, then that's unfair.
And Gil gets to roll.
It doesn't matter, I nat 1.
Oh, okay. Let me roll intimidation with my plus 14.
That is not going to work on me.
It's true, I think you've... no, you have beat me in a fight once, so I don't think that really has much of an effect. Anyway.
No, I'm just vibing. Rem's staying
here. I'm not forcing Rem to do anything or not do anything. Regardless of what happens, I'm just kind of hoping that Suna makes it back.
Gotcha.
Mostly okay, at the very least. I'm not saying fine, because I mean... it's a big tower.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'll examine...
210 feet of them.
I'll examine the stairwell if Gil takes me over. Does anything stand out to me?
It's the same thing. It's this naturally seeming staircase that spirals down into darkness and past your dark vision.
Are there no markings from what I can see?
It looks completely, completely natural.
And didn't Zex throw something down there?
A natural staircase? Like, not man-made?
It does not look man-made.
He threw something down there, right?
Yeah, a stone with light, like a lit up stone that then fell for at least 5 seconds and then disappeared into the void.
And he, like, there was no sound or anything.
No sound.
Yeah, that's wild to me.
I don't think Rem has to make a nature check to know that staircases don't happen in nature.
Wait. I have...
it doesn't look pretty.
Ooh.
But it does work as a spiral staircase.
Thing for this, hold on. I think I have useful...
A spiral staircase located locally within your halls of glory in this time of year? It's a little wild.
I'm going to look at Rem and ask, do you think we have 10 minutes?
Probably.
I would like to cast... clairvoyance.
Clairvoyance to the bottom of the hole?
To 1 mile down, as far as I can go, if that's okay. The bottom of the hole or on the staircase.
Okay.
I told you I had a thing. It might not get me anywhere, but it might.
Oh, you do have dark vision.
Uh-huh.
In an obvious location that is unfamiliar to you.
I think down a big hole is pretty obvious.
Yeah, if he says down 1 mile, that's down 1 mile. If it clips into the ground, like, that's the risk he runs, but...
But I know there's at least a relative bottom to it. At least...
You're just, like very you're just saying bottom of the hole.
Yeah, just, like, down the hole the entire mile.
Let me see.
And wherever that puts me, it puts me. It gives me information any which way.
Clairvoyance?
Clairvoyance.
I am going to have you.
It says familiar to you, a place you have visited or seen before.
Or an obvious location. Read the entire thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Obvious location that's unfamiliar. I mean, this is a big old hole. I think it's pretty obvious.
Feels obvious to me.
I'm going to have you roll a D100, Gil.
Lay it on me.
Ooh. For where the sensor appears and how much information you're able to get, because there are some spots that give you information.
And I'm choosing seeing. I mean,
I'd assume you're choosing seeing.
I can switch to hearing, but I mean, okay. You know, that's entirely mid. 59.
Mid.
That's almost exactly mid, actually.
Okay. Let's see.
I'm gonna be.
You aren't gonna see anything too wild.
But just enough to make me interested. Hopefully.
I think what you see.
Oh no.
Is a little striking. It's.
Blackham?
A statue.
Oh.
A figure. With a. Strong set of shoulders, wearing this armor that's a little hard to pick out in the dark. You don't see colors with your dark vision.
Right.
You can see the circle, the half circle of a wide-brimmed hat that goes behind him. It is currently not on his head. It is hanging behind him around his, like, attached via a string around his neck. But it is a wide-brimmed hat. And his hands look like they are clasped together. But you don't know for sure. The reason for that is because they are hidden by a shield and sword combination.
Mm.
Please. No. I'm going to describe it, what the shield looks like.
Okay.
This shield looks to be a, well, not the largest shield, a shield that probably takes up about maybe a third of the man's figure. It has a gemmed outline along it. But the front of it is mostly barren. Nothing on it. Until you squint. I wonder if you know this symbol. Make a religion check.
Oh, no. Is it possible that I can be actively, like, describing what I am seeing?
You want guidance, don't you?
I mean, guidance.
I think he wants
advantage from Rem, like
inspiration.
Yeah, just like, I don't know, something.
I mean, I'm on your shoulder, so I guess I can guide you.
I can hit you with an inspiration if Jacob will let me.
Sure.
So that's a D10 and a D4?
D12.
Yeah. D12 and a D4. Well, good thing my religion's a flat roll. Okay, could be worse. Hey, I'm fine. That's a 24.
Nice. I'll give you the answer at the end, but we've got bonus points if someone can recognize it through the description.
Knock off 50 HP for Lackham's health if we do.
I was thinking more of just like inspiration for you actually remembering it.
Or that works too.
You see one large, simple star in the middle of the shield, and aligning outside of the point, spaced evenly, smaller stars encircling it, 7 to be exact.
Oh, the 7 ascended.
That's Mistress symbol. Yeah, what the fuck? Mistral.
There we go.
It's like the easiest symbol.
Gilgamesh didn't get it off the bat.
Oh no, the 7 ascended. Oh yeah, I know them.
The 7 ascended are a different symbol.
Seven stars, man.
They're a bastardized symbol of Mistra. The 7 ascended is the ruby red skull with 7 symbols around it that each depict the 7 in a unique fashion. This is uniform.
Oh, right, 7 stars.
Yes. So, Rem said Mistra first.
It's easy. What the hell?
What the hell?
Rem can have... Rem, you can have an inspiration.
How does that work?
At any time... you can, when you make a roll, you can say, I would like to use my inspiration, and you re-roll the d20.
That's going to be very relevant.
True.
Would someone write that down somewhere?
Normally people write it on their character sheet, but you do you. Yeah, you say this, and the three of you all just say, Mistra. And then, Gil, you look a little bit higher. You were so focused on looking at being a warrior, his weapons, his stature. You forget for a second, maybe it's because you grew up around Dragonborn, the statue is a Dragonborn.
Oh. The cogs in my mind are turning.
Is it Donovan?
That's what I'm thinking. I mean, who else would it be? If it's somebody else.
It could be Lackham.
I guess. I mean...
Lackham is a female dragonborn form, and this is a male dragonborn.
So they all kind of look the same, don't they?
Wow.
No. I don't think so.
Dragonborns have, like, sexual dimorphism or anything like that?
They have differences. They have, like...
titties?
I think
taking away your inspiration.
I'm genuinely asking. Is this like a... Disney chest based situation?
No more inspiration.
If I remember correctly, Dragonborns are normally told apart by the setting of their jaw and eyebrows, as well as the thinner shoulders of females.
Dragonborns have eyebrows? Oh.
Eyebrow ridges. Okay. They don't actually have eyebrows.
All
right. Actually, I wonder if Gilgamesh... Does Gilgamesh's picture have eyebrows? It does not. It just has scars.
I don't think so.
It does not. But yeah.
So, I mean, can I... I guess there's no real way that I would know what Donovan looks like, though, is there?
You've seen him.
You met him.
You've made the connection. You study his face more closely. Yeah. Yeah, that's him.
So, is it safe to assume that this is what you would consider Donovan's tomb, maybe?
Feels tomby to me.
I mean, it feels pretty tomby to me, too.
That's up for you to consider.
I mean, I guess, because I have 10 minutes of this.
You're just going to describe Donovan?
Look around. What else?
I was going to say, I want to look around.
Listen.
And that's, yeah, and then I was going to switch to hearing. So if I look around and see nothing else of like relevance or importance, I'll switch to hearing for a little while.
There is this statue, at least with the 60 feet, looks to be standing near by itself.
And I'm assuming this is the bottom. Like, yeah. Is it safe to say that it's the bottom?
You said bottom of hole.
Okay. I mean, yeah.
This is where it puts you.
So then...
You listen.
Can I... Yeah, I was going to say, I want to switch to hearing.
Unfortunately, the only thing you can hear is the draft of wind moving through the stale air of a tomb undisturbed.
I want to ask Rem or Zex to throw another rock down.
I'll cast a light on another pebble and toss her down the hole.
Are you listening, Alpha?
I was going to say, I'm still listening, so then we can do like math things and figure out how deep this hole is.
And technically, the other pebble before that should have still been lit up because it's been less than an hour. No rain requirement on light.
I believe, does light reset if you use it a second time?
It's concentration.
So do I? Light, I guess I won't see it though.
No, light isn't concentration, but it does reset if I use it a second time.
Mm-hmm.
So I would have seen it go out, but I'm listening. So
yeah. You hear it kind of snap, and then the rock, you hear the sounds of like shattered pieces.
Oh, like, the rock broke.
The rock broke.
And how many seconds did it take to get down here?
I don't want to do the math in my head, so I'll just like tell you.
You can just tell me how deep it is. That's fine. That's better for me, honestly.
It's good for me. let me double check my notes so I am sure. This is looking to be about probably just underneath 10,000 feet.
Wow. That's quite the hole.
Quite the hole.
How many rounds would it take to fall down there if you just jumped?
He does not have the range to get down there.
No, that sensor can only go down a mile.
Oh, mile.
Down a mile. Well, that's okay.
It's fine.
It's we have fun good. Here. We have fun here. Yeah, that is over a mile, isn't it? It's a mile and a half.
It's 2 miles.
I was gonna say it's more than that, yeah.
It's a little
because a mile is. I should have known this. A mile is 5,000. Yeah, it's. I thought it was 5,280, but whatever. It doesn't matter.
I thought it was 5,282.
Oh, okay, then maybe.
So
maybe
not. To fall a mile, I just double checked. It is 32 seconds. To fall a mile. So it took. Probably about like 40-45 seconds.
Holy shit.
Wow, that's a big old hole, man.
Well, when it's an ancient relic that has been like sealed forever and referred to as like the lock. Yeah.
It'd take 20 rounds to fall down there from the top.
I bet there's a
wow.
I bet there's a Dollar General down there.
You think I'm uncultured? I mean, it's a Waffle House.
It's probably a Waffle House down there too.
How, like, feasibly round trip down and up without any exploration? How long would it take? Like, literally, get to the bottom of the stairs and you turn around, go back up.
2 hours.
Yeah.
To scale a mile, I would say because it's not, it's a staircase. You can move down it, but you're not going to be running. You're not going to be booking it. It's dark. You don't, like, you don't know whether it's, like, how treacherous it is, how unstable it is. You're going to be careful. And so I'd be, I don't know, you guys could probably, like, scale, like, a mean half an hour all the way down. Maybe a little bit longer, like an hour to get back up, maybe a little over an hour.
Inconvenient for sure.
I have an expressway.
Jump.
Are you going to swim your way down this hole?
Well, but because of how it would take like the full 20 rounds to do that, you could technically react and then just feather fall the last, like, or even cast fly and just fly down the rest.
The biggest thing is that
turn every 500 feet.
Yeah, the biggest thing though that I would remind you of is the fact that you can't see past 60 feet.
Bro.
And that ground comes up fast.
Yeah.
Do you,
but
James?
James.
I'm gonna level with you, from me to you. If you have enough faith in yourself to go skydiving at night, with no reference light, because you know how far down it is, and you know when to deploy your chute. I'm super happy for you.
You're saying is if it's like the easiest thing in the world.
I have only one question.
Bad. You can count.
Right.
Yes.
How many D6s?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
More than you guys have taken like three times over.
No. Give me an actual number, because technically there's a chance that I could get to.
Technically I could hit the ground that hard and be fine.
Yeah.
Technically I could do that.
If you give me, I don't know. If we try,
it would be 700. It would be 700 D6.
Damn, I don't know if I can survive that many. I don't think I can.
Death ward.
Death ward me. Did you death ward me?
You would still be taking massive damage shock, which can outright kill you. Which can get through death ward.
Isn't it?
You can die through shock.
I would be taking at bare minimum, like three times my HP, which I think would just outright kill me, so.
Yeah.
What if I do like my relentless rage? Right. If I do like my relentless rage, it'll set me to one, and then I'd be fine.
So you'd be being dealt around 2,500 points of damage.
But I'll be raging, and if I'm set to zero, then I just go back.
If I death ward myself and jump with this shield, it pops twice, I'm fine.
Massive damage is still a thing.
Guys,
I know that we all love Baldur's Gate. You can see the little skull and crossbones. Okay? It does not give a shit about death ward. It will kill you.
The warning of death ward!
You can't let me...
I actually want
to
do this.
I can't believe I'm about to say this to my 3-year season D&D group. Don't jump down the fucking hole.
Oh, fine. I guess I'll sit up here and pout since you're not letting me jump.
Do not jump if you're not ready for the consequences.
Too damn
ready for the consequences.
The consequences.
You guys... I welcome them.
I am ready for the consequences, though.
I mean, yeah, speaking as the person who single-handedly went into the cyclone, yeah, you're probably the most ready for consequences.
The consequences to a certain extent. I'm an enabler.
That's, yeah.
So we know how many feet down it is. Can we just teleport and say X amount of feet down into the ground?
That is 100% within the rules.
That's a dangerous game to play, though.
I wouldn't do that.
I would almost argue more dangerous than jumping in the hole itself.
Can you get back up is the thing here.
You can walk.
When you attempted to teleport into it first time, you got shunted.
Yeah, I do remember that. But it was also a roll, if I'm remembering.
No,
but
this is different. You were told that you were, like, physically shunted. Like, you didn't fuck it up. You were prevented, is what you were told.
No.
I was not told prevented.
JC, that's what you told him, right?
I'm reframing. Do what you're doing. I am ready to dole out consequences like hotcakes.
Just do it.
I do like me a consequence.
I dare you.
I don't like hotcakes that much. I prefer waffles.
Waffles are pretty good.
But hotcakes are also pretty good, I will say.
I like the crunch of a waffle.
Fair. That is a nice appeal.
What is this?
Listen, man, I want to jump down the hole, but you already like basically told me no, so
We've been here contemplating the hole for a while. We get a call. I found Lackham. How are we reacting to that information?
I want to jump down the hole.
Kind of expected, to be honest.
I think we should wait for Sunan to get back before we make any decisions. Like, fight-wise, like, I'm not at my best, but, like,
I mean...
Well, I'm damn near close to my best. I use 1/3 level spell. Yeah, I'm pretty crisp.
I mean, why not? It might take us a while to get there, though.
But we could jump in the hole.
We're not jumping into the hole.
JC, how far away is the big obsidian thingy thing from us? How long would it take us to get there?
It's like if you guys are just booking it.
Yeah, if we're just running.
Yeah, it's going to take you about the same amount of time that Suna took, so, like...
What if I just cast Teleport?
Then it would be just in the hole. Then it would be instant.
We're fighting today. We are fighting today. Don't do that.
So what, it's like, wasn't it like 20, 30 minutes? Do I remember that right?
30 to 45, yeah.
Stop. Oof.
Get this out of here.
Sam
just posted a link to the Van Halen song Jump.
It's a good song. There's no connotation to be had.
I guess we don't have the cart though, do we? That's just kind of been a nebulous thing.
Yeah.
It's just kind of
at home.
Is it? I thought we kind of lost it and then just like left it at that.
No, it's at home. It should be. I didn't check. Is it?
The cart, we lost the cart. The carriage, we still own. Probably.
I don't know the difference between the two, I'm going to be completely honest.
The carriage it's the megabus, the tour bus.
I'm familiar with the megabus. I thought the cart and the carriage were the same thing.
The cart and the carriage are the same thing because you're uncultured, but no.
The cart was stolen.
The cart was stolen by some kobold fuckboys.
I mean, is
the
house
should be at home.
Is the carriage on the way? Is there a way we can pick that up like halfway through, or is
what
that
we need it for?
Are we really gonna run for half an hour?
Yes.
Oh,
we'll
Jesus!
Be out
okay.
Out of shape, just run.
No,
you literally move 40 feet. You almost move double what I move. I'm broomless in Seattle now.
I'm just trying to streamline
You're
getting there.
You're actually going to have to carry me.
Fuck, that's gonna slow me down too, isn't it?
It'll still be faster than if I move on my own.
I have a solution.
Don't you dare cast a fucking
spell,
you hear me?
We're not casting spells.
Shadow Wizard Money Gang?
That's almost a worse solution than jumping down the hole.
No, I think the hole is the worst solution here. Let's just wait for Suna to get back.
Okay. That works too. I'm okay with that.
Suna has not said help or anything like that. And I have faith that Suna would be able to at least say help.
I mean, but like,
I wouldn't fight Suna.
I'd
probably win, but I wouldn't do it.
Saying like, I found Lackham or a Lackham, like, I mean.
A Lackham and Lackham are very, like, two different statements. I am not perturbed.
It's actually Lackham.
I am not perturbed by at all. You could run into a Lackham at your local gas station at this point.
I mean, but we don't know if it's
Lackham because I had no reason. I had no way.
No, that has to be actual Lackham. You can only have one simulacrum at a time.
We killed one.
Okay, but this is also a demigod. So, like, I mean, fuck, they could have five simulacrums. I don't know.
Oh yeah, I love the
I said a Lackham because I couldn't determine if it was Lackham or a simulacrum.
Exactly.
Similacum.
Similacum, yeah!
It's been like a month now.
I guess I...
Oh. Anyway, let's wait for Suna to get back.
Twiddle our thumbs.
Okay.
We can go down a little bit.
All right, can I be back now?
You can go down about 200 feet, but then you gotta come back up.
I mean, we probably won't find anything, will we?
I'm casting light.
Okay.
Oh, good, my dark vision.
You guys illuminate and can see that for the first bit of, like, exploring the hole, which we can say, like, 120 feet. How about that? It is just going down. I would like... Zex and Gil went down, correct?
Mm-hmm.
You two can make
Rem
an...
did too?
Did Rem go?
I mean, Rem's... Yeah, Rem's not staying behind.
Nime, are you going down?
How much would I bet you? Nime
says yes in all caps. I would like emphatically all four of you to make intelligence checks.
Oh.
Gross.
That's not the result I wanted from this.
Can I use like a dedicated anymore. Skill, perhaps?
18?
You do not... There is a dedicated skill to this. You do not have it. It is a specialized skill.
I'm a little stupid. I probably don't.
Is it the stone masonry thing that dwarves get?
Yes.
And like rock gnomes?
Yes. And mason tools.
I would say my cousin probably told me, but like I don't have any cousins.
Intelligence checks.
I got an 8.
I'm
I know nothing.
18.
Okay.
And a 12.
Okay.
Can I be guided? I don't know. I don't. Well, good choice.
16. Zex.
I told you the number.
And Nime. As you all kind of go down, it's small, but it's noticeable. The staircase is widening. You guys started at this cone, like the tip of this conar structure or this dome-like structure. And the staircase is getting wider. You're lengthening the paces. It's just hard to see because the light illuminates the staircase and then the void of darkness. But the hole is wider the further you go down. And now is the time where you guys decide, are you doing an expedition or are you going back up and waiting for Suna?
I'm going back up.
Okay.
Fine. I'll go back up.
Just this once.
This once. You let me down there again, I'm never coming back.
All right. You guys head back up. and are kind of moving. You can see Silex just kind of watching. And standing at the edge of the crater, Tara has come down into the pit and she kind of yells, like calls out as you guys exit the staircase. Are all of you all right?
For the moment.
You're fine, all right.
I just watched, seemed like the heavens hit you and then you decided you're good for it and just went into a hole it made, so.
But did we die?
She starts counting. Besides the one that flew up into the air, I think you're doing great.
Would have been funnier if she just, like, didn't see me leave.
You know who would have survived that?
She just looks at you and kind of crosses her hands. Her crosses her arms across her chest.
I appreciate the moxie. Try not to do that again, please.
I'll see what I can do.
I'll be right back.
About this time, you hear the slight breeze above that connotates a disturbance in the air as Suna coasts back into the Halls of Glory. You can see that her hair has become worse for wear, kind of whipped and like pulled down by her shoulders. Suna, you've arrived back and can see that the shell, the topper, possibly, of the stone has been moved. And they're all gathered around.
Did you go down there?
Just a little bit.
Find anything?
It gets wider as we go down. That's the only thing we know.
You don't know anything else?
I was going to say, technically, am I allowed to share the knowledge that was imparted to me incorrectly?
Yeah, you can say what you want. You're the one who saw it.
I will inform Suna of the large statue and that it is most definitely Donovan's tomb. It's just, you know, 10,000 feet deep, so it's kind of a problem.
Donovan? I will say it is not a large statue. It is just a statue of a larger stanced dragonborn. This isn't like the...
big statue energy.
Big statue energy. Big brick energy.
Yeah.
So it is Donovan's.
I'm a connoisseur.
Yes.
I did not confirm.
As far as I'm concerned, yes. I have no reason to believe anything else.
Okay, I'm going to work off the knowledge that Gil has told me, yes, this is indeed Donovan's tomb. Even though that is wrong.
Okay.
I found a Lacum, only because I don't know if it's actually Lacum. But she seems to be doing something on top of the tower with, like, it's all, like, swirling around and seems bad. Mm. But everything she does seems bad, so par for the course. I think we should probably head that way soon. Like, very soon.
Let's go right now. And Gil is going to start walking. People go with him, no big deal. But Gil is going to start walking.
Zexual tomb. Silex, carry Rem.
Silex.
Good choice.
Shifts, grabs Rem, and starts just... Rem makes a strength save. Silex makes a strength. Rem is with Silex. 11 versus 16.
I guess I'll just like chill on the broom until Rem says.
Okay. Rem will probably take it back shortly, but
oh, I'm sure.
You all are heading towards the tower?
I mean, sounds like it.
Yes.
All right. Sure.
Let's do it.
Is there any final things that you want to say to Terra, to Lixen, to Jensen, anyone that is in the halls? Any warnings, anything that you need to get off your chest before you go to the town square?
I have some, points things that I need to do. Can I just, like, text that to you?
Sure.
Okay.
And, Zex, you were saying something?
Stay put, stay vigilant, don't go down the hole.
Alright. Zivin kind of is, kind of pulled himself together. Should we be expecting more undead coming? The pact didn't last long.
We don't know. Completely honestly, no idea. Maybe just keep your eye out, and it seemed like you guys handled these ones pretty okay, so.
Well, once we knew what was happening.
Yeah.
It didn't hurt that you guys were here.
Glad never hurts.
Yeah. Well, I'll keep the kids away from the hole. And, you'll be back. Right?
Do I see the children?
So the dark elf girl has been, like, has stayed on the northern side of the arena. She hasn't kind of moved from the stands that have been being cannibalized for the barricades when you guys showed up. The half-orc that was nearly killed, he's still hiding out in the bedding house, most likely probably getting treated for his wounds.
There's no point to it, but I was going to make eye contact with them both and say, if you enter the hole, you will immediately die.
Jesus Christ.
Look,
I think, honestly,
was a lot about deterrence.
Look, I think they're probably traumatized enough to not go snooping around at the moment.
They did watch us get alpha striked, so I mean, that's probably pretty scary.
Look, I know more about children than Gil. I know this works.
That's true.
That's true.
Children respond to deterrence.
I don't think Gil knows where kids come from.
Just like the countries.
Mm.
They respond to deterrence.
I'm pretty sure Gil knows where children come from.
I don't know.
You come from a tribal nation. I'm 100% sure you know where they come from.
That's a good point, actually.
Yeah. All right.
You probably know where they come from more than fucking Nime knows where they come from.
Nime,
I mean, she is a rabbit. Maybe not.
Nime knows where kids come from. She can't. I feel bad. Jazz can't defend herself. Her computer's on the fritz.
She couldn't defend herself even if she was here.
Wow. She's gonna get on the mic just to rip you a new one.
Let her.
But really robotic in the process.
I mean, we'll
what
see.
What the fuck did you just say to me?
Tell me about September 21st, 1987. Anyway, final parting words to the people. This is gonna suck ass.
That's what you say.
No, but like,
those are good final words, though. It's true.
Ew.
God, I'll remember that for the next time I'm about to go in a battle.
This is, I don't even know what to say to them.
Gosh.
It's this, I think what's going to happen is you guys have said your, those who have said things say things, and it ends with you guys, Lixen, Terra, and Ziven, kind of the two lines of you, the adventurers. And, well, you guys standing across from each other, they, at the very least, have an idea of what you're going to do. And there's no chance that you guys want to explain it more in depth. The thought of fighting Lakum has hung over this group like a foul fog for days. And Nime steps forward, kind of bridging the gap between the two lines of people. Gives a soft smile. And embraces Ziven. He tenses up for a second. You guys see his breath kind of go out of his body as a sigh. As he returns the hug.
May I also give Hera a hug?
You embrace Terra, and you do hear that kind of stifled laugh from her. That don't tell me you're getting emotional on me now.
I'm never emotional.
She laughs to herself again, but you do feel her squeeze your shoulder tightly. both of you pull out of the embrace. Give one final look. And head towards the door. Leaving behind the survivors, Halls of Glory, to fight not just the final ascended, but the one who's caused so much pain and misery. The one who's been watching you longer than you've known they've existed. And who more than anything else right now wants to sunder you, turn your bones to ash. And you walk towards her tower. And that's where we're going to end the session for tonight. Walking towards the tower.
I suppose this could wait until tomorrow, could it? I only need like 15-ish hours.
We need I
wouldn't be opposed other than she seems to be up to some shit. And I don't know if we should wait.
I mean, we've been airstriked. What else can she do?
A lot.
A second airstrike?
We've literally had entire, meteors cast upon us. At this point, anything can happen.
I'm mostly worried about her doing something while we're sleeping.
I don't think we need to sleep. I think we just go straight for it.
I think we should sleep. I know we're walking our way there. I think...
She's already used a legendary resistance, so you gotta, we gotta just go for it now.
I don't have divine intervention.
Yeah, except I've... So, here, you want to hear my spell slots real quick? Because I just fucked myself if we're sleeping.
Well, I mean... No, because we're not sleeping.
You fucked yourself if we're sleeping?
So, I have... I have 3/3, 3/4, a 5th, and an 8.
Yeah, see, you're fine. We don't need to sleep.
Well,
do you think we should be sleeping?
JC, what do you think? Do you think we should sleep?
I think that it's so wonderful that I have 5 people here that are willing to come back week after week and deal with my villains. I don't know if this is the first time I've confessed it on stream, but Lakum is wholeheartedly my favorite of the 7 Ascended, and I think it spills over into the actual game. She's just so evil. She's so messed up. And I can't wait to see what you guys do. But you found something that lies beneath the temple. And you know where Lakum... At least you hope to the gods that it's Lakum is.
Can we get a real Lakum out here for
one? You need a real Lakum, please? Aisle 4?
I mean it legendary resistance.
That's yep. true.
Yeah.
I mean, pretty sure it's Lakum.
You would hope that a simulacrum wouldn't be able to do that,
If the simulacrum could do that, I think it would have done that.
But I don't know, maybe that's the ace up the sleeve. But also, I don't know.
I'm very
it has to be right.
I'm very excited, but I'm gonna end this off. Thank you everybody so much for watching. Thank you Ark for coming in and lurking around. Thank you Helminia, Alpha, Suzanne, Jazz, and James for being here with me. And if you're watching live on Twitch, make sure to follow. And if you're watching the rerun on YouTube, you're a saint. And make sure to subscribe. See more D&D. But marching on the tower next week. I'll see you next time. Bye, guys. Have a good night.